as a guy that fought Robbie and had to prepare for Robbie and then went to war with Robbie, what makes him so special?
And then lost to Robbie. Thanks for that. I appreciate that, bringing up that nightmare. It's his fourth quarter comeback. You know, you talk about any one of his fights, especially his last couple, he's coming back in the end to win the fight. Really, really coming back from the end. It's tough to train for a guy like that because then you have to have enough left in your tank to be able to battle back at the same time that he's battling. And he forces the position. He keeps the fight where he wants to keep it, which is on his feet. We take him down. He doesn't stay down very long. He's very, very wily and greasy on the ground. Not saying he's using any kind of oil, but he's very good about getting back up to his feet. So to prepare for him, it's really tough to prepare for a guy that's a lefty that hits hard as hell, can hit harder later in the fight than he can in the beginning of the fight, and has a gas tank that runs forever. Since he dropped down to 70, and we fought as 85, he fought at 85 for a while. He dropped down to 70 at the UFC. He's actually better. So he's gotten better over the years. And what makes it even more difficult to train for is now you're looking at a guy that without having wraps on and gloves on, he has cinder blocks in his hands. Then you wrap him on top of it, it makes it even harder. That's much more difficult. You can't get prepared for a guy that's going to hit you that hard.
Woodley, obviously, athletic freak. Robbie has the experience. He has the pedigree and all that. What do you see in this matchup? When you just put those two in the octagon, what do you see?
Well, here's the thing with Woodley. Explosive power, incredibly gifted athlete. Aggressive, goes straight forward the entire time. Jumps in. You know, doesn't have to be inside the pocket because he can jump in and hit you with one, two punches and put you out and put you unconscious. Of course, that we talked about, Lawler can go late in the rounds. He needed to go. He also is aggressive, likes coming forward, likes staying in the pocket. It's going to be an interesting matchup. Unfortunately, I think Lawler might lose this one because I think Woodley can win the first three rounds. Now, my personal prediction is that Woodley's going to finish the fight in the third round because Lawler's going to believe, I can't get touched. I'm not going to be, he can't hit me anymore because I see every punch coming at me, and let his guard down a little bit. Because you always see Robbie drop his hands and then come back and hit you with two punches. He'll drop his hands, and that's when Woodley's going to jump in on him. I think at some point it's going to happen. If it gets through the third round and gets into the fourth round, I think now Lawler's in a position where I'm stuck. I've lost the first three rounds. I've got to battle back, and I've got to win by knockout, which makes him very dangerous, but makes him very sloppy as well because now he's got to hit you with everything he has every single time. If it goes in the fourth and fifth round, I am going to be on pins and needles because then Woodley can be knocked out very easily at that point because, like I said, Lawler gets better as it goes later. When you look at Woodley, though, as it goes in the fourth and fifth round, his cardio drops down lower and lower and exponentially faster. He gets way worse in the middle of the fifth round than he was in the beginning of the fourth round. It's horrible to watch what happened. Hopefully, I haven't trained with either one of these guys in his training camp. Hopefully, both of them have improved some of their mistakes, and Woodley's got to improve his late cardio game.
You know, with his time here, it's obvious that Robbie Lawler is the adopted son of Hawaii mixed martial arts. With that being said, even though you think there's a chance that maybe he does not survive this one, this could be the late inning rally that doesn't come true, this is going to be an exciting fight, isn't it?
Yeah, make no mistake about it. I want Lawler to win, but I think Woodley will win. So I want Lawler to pull this off because he is one of us. It's crazy to see. He's not only one of us, meaning Hawaiian, but he's also one of us, like my era. He's the last guy that started fighting when I started fighting and is still continuing to fight. He's it. Him and Henderson are the last two, and Henderson's already announced after his next fight, he's out. Lawler has no plans of retiring anytime soon. He will continue our era on into however long, you know, four or five more years. With Lawler, if he loses this fight, there'll be an immediate rematch. There's no way around. They're not going to let a guy like that not have a rematch come immediately back in, especially in that weight class. If Lawler wins this, that's his last true test. There's nobody else in the weight class that can hang with him at this point. Steven Thompson is a little gamey with him, could actually swing in there and pull it off, but then they keep stepping over Wonder Boy. Not necessarily on purpose, but just because marketability-wise, Lawler's becoming very marketable, and you have to match him up with somebody else that's very marketable, and I don't think they have anybody else in the game that can hang with him that's marketable, they can actually beat Lawler. So after this fight, if he beats Woodley, it's it. Like he'll be the next GSP who beat Matt Hughes' record, which it's kind of weird. It all seems to be at the same weight class. Mm-hmm. So he can all of a sudden now go through and be a champ, you know, 10, 12, 13, 14 times in a row, defend the title that many times, and no one can catch him.